There's nothing in the line about avoiding crisis, conflict and war. There's everything in the line about the inevitability of China's rise, the inevitability of, you know, Zhonghua Minzu, Wei Da Fu Xing, the great renaissance of the Chinese people, code language for becoming the preeminent regional and global power by mid-century. The line is clear that China must prepare for dangers in times of peace and also prepare for the storm. So that's the script being delivered internally. So therefore, in the rest of the world, obviously there's a predisposition to seek to avoid war. I'm in that camp. I think war is generally a pretty bad thing if you've got any mind for history. But I think where the intersection of the interests between China and the US lie is avoiding war by accident in the near term and using deterrence to prevent war in the long term. So these are the two, as it were, strands of the argument outlined in that book.
And are you really...